Everyone, welcome back. I hope you're doing great. So let's start with the next set of experiments. Let me show you the title first, then we'll dive in straight away. This is experiment number 7, which is exploring router and virtual LAN security, then setting up an ACL using CISCO packet tracer student edition. Why we are focusing on student edition? Basically, student edition comes free with no foundations, no limitations as such for experimentation purpose. So you can obviously download that student edition version and start with the experiments. So let's see what we exactly want to do. The first thing is we need to create a network according to the diagram given in the CISCO's packet tracer. The second step would be we need to apply routing information protocol between the various routers present inside the network. This is similar to connecting them physically, but we are doing it virtually on CISCO packet tracer. Third step would be to apply some access control lists. What are access control lists? We will see it in the later parts. And finally, we will apply some filters to create a virtual LAN. So basically, this experiment will be a three-part experiment. Part one will be focusing on creating the network and applying routing information protocol. Part two will deal with access control lists, and the third part will deal with virtual LANs. Let's see how it goes. So first thing first is we need to create the network according to the diagram given. Okay, so this is the diagram given to you. You need to create a network of this fashion. Okay, first thing is there is this particular network, 192.168.1.0. This is first network, this is the second network, and this is the third network. We are having two routers and two switches. Three PCs are connected using these two switches and two routers. The very first thing is we need to create this diagram as it is. Then we will apply the IP addresses and then create two routers over here, two switches over here. Finally, we would like to apply routing information protocol in both these routers, so that we can communicate from this PC to this PC or vice versa, from this network to this network through RIP. So this is our very first aim. So let's start the CISCO packet tracer. I have already designed this network, but you can design it from scratch. Very first thing is you need to have the routers and the computers. Okay, so let's start. Let's see this diagram, and accordingly we need to draw our network. Okay, so very first thing is we need to apply the routers. For example, pick any router. Then we need the switches. Here we can see the switch. Draw as it is. Then we need the end devices, which means the computers. It can be computers, it can be printer, anything. Okay, like this. Next step is we need to draw the links or the cables, connections. So I prefer automatically choosing the connection type. Simply click here and here. Simply connect it according to the diagram given on the left hand side. Depending upon the device, whether it be a switch or a router, the connection or the cabling will change automatically because we have selected the automatic settings over here. Next thing is, you don't need these color coding. I have just simplified, I have just used it for simplification purpose to differentiate between the various networks. So what is the very next thing you need to do? You need to apply the IP addresses on the machines. If you can see carefully over here, these are the IP addresses of the machines: 192.168.1.100, 2.100, and 2.101. So that is what we need to do next. So click on the machines. Go to the desktop settings. See, these are the various settings available inside the machine. You can go to IP config and set up the IP address. So what is the IP address of the first machine? It is 192.168.1.100. subnet mask will be automatically selected because it is a class C address, and we know that in a class C address, the first 3 bytes are reserved for network part. The last particular part is reserved for host part. So that's why it came automatically. Now, what is this default gateway? The default gateway is nothing but the router through which the communication will go. So for this network, this is the default gateway. So I need to put the IP address of this particular router over there. 192.168.1.1. Okay. And save it. Okay. That's it. Similarly, you need to do the settings for this particular PC and this PC. So I will pause the video for a minute and get back to you once you have completed setting up the IP addresses. Okay, so I hope you have set up the IP addresses for all the 3 PCs over here. You can cross check with what I have set up over here. This is the IP address of the first PC. The router or the default gateway will be this, that is 192.168.2.1. This will be same for both the machines because we are routing our communication through that router. Okay, so quickly let's see whether I'm able to communicate from this machine to this machine. For the best, what you can do is you can simply click over here. See, add a simple PDU, click over here, select this machine and this machine. You can see the output over here. It's coming out as failed. Why we are not able to communicate from this machine to this machine? You can see it clearly that from this to this, there is a green link. Similarly, from here to here, that is between the switch and the machines, there is a green link. But between the switch and the router, there is no green link, which simply says that we are able to communicate from this machine to the switch, but further communication is not possible because we have not applied any routing information protocol or any kind of routing protocol on the routers. So that is our next step. We need to provide some information about routing to the routers and the various machines. Okay, so the next step would be applying IP addresses to the routers. Because we haven't applied any IP address to these routers, we simply know what is the route, what is the IP address of router 0 and router 1, which is 192.168.1.1 and 2.1. But we haven't applied any IP address to the interfaces of these routers. So that is our next step. So click on the router. But before that, just check the interface names. If you keep your mouse cursor over this red dot, you will come to know that this is interface FA00. If you are not able to see it carefully, have a look over here. If I keep the cursor over here on that red dot, you will come to know that the interface name is FA0/0. Same way, if you click here, it will show you FA0/1. So now you know which are the interfaces and what are the names of the interfaces. So let's start giving IP addresses to those interfaces. Click on it, go to config. There are two interfaces shown, FA00 and FA01. Click on FA00. Now I know the IP address of that interface, which is 192.168.1.1. Subnet mask will be by default. Don't miss one particular step, which is very important, which is this port status. We have to press on this checkbox, which is on. So what we are doing is we are turning on the interface. If you carefully look over here, the red dot has now become green, which means the interface from this side is now open for communication. Similar thing we have to do for this particular interface, which is FA01. Again, the same step, but now the IP address is this 192.168.3.1 because we are communicating with the 3 wala network over here. Getting it? Okay. So it will be 192.168.3.1. Again, subnet mask will be by default. Don't forget to click on this on button. Okay. Now you can see that this, even after pressing the on button, it's still red. Why is the case? Because we haven't applied the IP addresses on this router yet. Because this interface is connected this connected with this router. So we need to provide the IP addresses on this router as well. Otherwise, this interface will not be connected properly. Okay, so half of the part is done. For the next half, go to this router. But before that, check the interface names. They are FA01 and FA00. So now we are applying IP address to FA00, which is this part, the IP address being 192.168.3.2. From here, subnet mask will be by default and press on. As soon as I press on, you can see the link has turned into a green link, which means now the routers are connected. The last part is providing IP address to this interface, which is FA01. The address is 192.168.2.1, as it's already given over here. Click on, and you will see that your link is getting activated. It takes 30 seconds approximately to switch from on and off and toggle between on off basically. So give some time to this particular machine to boot up. After they are all turned into green, you can again check whether the communication is happening or not. Okay, so let's see. It's still not turned on yet, so let's wait for some time and let's see how it goes. In the meantime, you can clear this cache. Okay, now it's turned green, so just check whether we are able to communicate between this machine and this machine. Same process, pick a packet. It's failed. Why? There's one more step left. What is that step? Have we applied the routing information protocol yet? No. We have simply given the IP addresses to these routers. But have we added the networks to the corresponding routers? That is, this router knows the IP address of this router, but it doesn't know the IP address of these machines. So what we need to do is, we need to provide routing information protocol on both the routers so that this PC comes to know the IP address of this PC and vice versa through the use of these routers. So that is our next step. Okay, so let's quickly see how we can apply RIP on the routers. It's very simple. It can be done even through coding or even through the GUI provided on Cisco Packet Tracer. So click on the router. Now we have to carefully look at the networks first. We see that there are two networks connected to this router. One is the network itself in which it is present, that is 3.0, and the network on the left hand side, that is 1.0. So we need to apply RIP on both these networks. So how we can do so? Go to config, click on RIP. There you can see add network. So what you can do is, you can simply add the IP address 192.168.3.0 for the upper network. Similarly, 192.168.1.0 for the left side network. The same process you can repeat for this router, the networks being 3.0 and 2.0. So let's see how it works. 192.168.3.0, 192.168.2.0. And now give it some time to initialize. I will get back to you when it's done. Okay, so let's quickly check whether the packets are getting delivered or not. From here to here, you can see previously it was coming as failed. Now it's successful. Again, try one more thing from this machine to this machine. Again, it's successful. You can try any possible combinations. What we are doing basically is, we have set up the routing information protocol in both the routers so that we can successfully communicate from one network to the other network. So that's it for this particular experiment. It is first part of this particular experiment on setting up virtual LANs and access control list. Stay tuned for part 2 and part 3, in which we will discuss upon how to set up virtual LANs and access control lists on this very network itself. Thank you so much. Thanks for attending.